darling. I'm sorry I neglected you, but I thought I'd sneak in a couple of hours on my book.
Your book?
Uh-huh.
First a column, now a book? What am I doing here? You could have brought my picture.
Oh, Ross, don't spoil things. Do you have any idea how long it's been since we've been away on a holiday?
Yeah, I was 7, you were 4.
Oh, I didn't know it was that recent. Oh, darling, I do love to be away with you.
I like hanging out with you, too. Listen, why don't we start the cocktail hour early today?
Are you trying to take advantage of a poor, defenseless woman?
Exactly.
Good.
I'll be a minute.
Then she said yes, and I...
Oh, sure.
I
2 rum Collins, please.
You got it, sir.
Excuse me. Is that your wife over there, the dear Beverly?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? Hey, man, she is really something else. She always has the right answer.
That's right. And she just gave me the right answer. That's why I'm taking a drink to her.
Hey, how about that, man? Guy left you a $3 tip and forgot to pay for the drinks.
When a mother-in-law comes to visit, how long should she stay?
Well, it depends whether you're home or not.
You a drink, darling?
In a moment, love. But why do we always pick on mother-in-laws? Why don't we pick on father-in-laws? Or for that matter, why don't we pick on ourselves? After all, none of us are perfect. Well, almost none of us.
You have a very popular wife.
Oh. Hey, how would you like a specialty of the house? Supervised and given the careful attention of Russ Blanchard himself.
Well, you just made me an offer I can't refuse.
Good.
Now that's a nice couple.
That's dear Beverly's husband.
Ain't misbehaving all by myself. You're cheating.